The Mayor of Kalgoorlie calls it the cancer of the bush. Queensland State MP Joanne Miller copped flak for likening it to concentration camps, but stood by the comparison. And today, a West Australian family have even released the details of a suicide note from their son in a bid to raise awareness about mental health issues plaguing the workforce. He recorded this video just days before he took his own life.
There's people out there what seem to be fine and deep down they're not, so...
And while the industry prefers to frame the issue of fly-in, fly-out mine work, or FIFO, as a matter of choice for smiling, coal dust-smeared workers, the reality of the situation was enough of a concern to prompt a parliamentary inquiry into the practice last year. There are 365 mines in operation in Australia, employing around 270,000 people. Over a third of those are FIFO workers, most living in cities like Brisbane and Perth, and travelling to mine sites in remote areas of Western Australia or the Bowen Basin. FIFO rosters are compressed work schedules. Employees generally work daily 12-hour shifts for 3 weeks, followed by 1 week off in which they return home. Proponents of the FIFO lifestyle say its benefits include a clear separation of work and home life, more quality time with loved ones during off periods, and high wages. But an increasing number of associated negative aspects have also been identified, including high rates of anxiety and depression among FIFO workers, increased stress on family relationships, sleep problems, and substance abuse. Despite these well-established links between FIFO and mental health problems, a recent report by Lifeline WA found that 1 in 5 workers claimed their industry did not have on-site mental health or on-site counselling facilities, and 1 in 10 reported their industry as not having an employment assistance program. And even money doesn't help, with workers earning over $200,000 reporting higher levels of stress at work. Despite all the obvious downsides, for one broke comedian, it was the only way to pay back the debt he'd accumulated. Xavier Toby later wrote a book about his time as a FIFO worker called Mining My Own Business. We spoke to him over Skype in Boston, where he is currently working.
Most guys, as soon as they finish work, have a drink in their hand and a cigarette in the other hand, and there was a lot of very heavy drinking that went on site. No one actually said anything, but I felt like that was the way that a lot of people cope with the loneliness and being away from the support networks. Because, it doesn't really matter what you do, you can't replace time with your family.
Alan Woodward from Lifeline also says this distance from support networks is what makes FIFO work uniquely difficult.
The research that Lifeline did last year, where we surveyed about 900 FIFO workers, it showed that their mental health issues were not greatly different to the rest of the Australian population. It was more an issue around how can they seek support? What are the things about a FIFO lifestyle that may be different?
Woodward said one key barrier to those in need of help was a lack of awareness of support services.
Even though in some cases we knew that the companies and the employers had employment assistance programs in place, a key barrier to seeking help is knowing what services are there and how to access them.
Cultural attitudes can also be a problem.
It was summed up in a quote from one worker who said, you need to just suck it up, princess. In other words, that you might be being soft if you admitted you were having troubles in life and needed help.
Xavier's experience mirrors this claim.
It's part of the male psyche, Australian male psyche. I did not meet one person who said that they had been to a mental health professional while they were out there, and I reckon they would have been called soft if they did.
But in addition to changing attitudes and awareness about mental health support, Xavier says mining companies could do more to make a more positive environment.
The only way, I think, to really make the situation like truly sustainable is to have a situation where the guys can fly home more often, but to try and get as close as possible to a normal, regular life.
But the cold reality is that FIFO work has taken off so strongly because it's a far cheaper way of doing business.
No, I'm talking to a few guys in the pub, we're sort of talking about this. This is at the mining site. And one guy said, they can't improve things because it'll reduce the profitability, and then the mining companies will go overseas. And then one guy said, well, mate, the stuff in the ground isn't going anywhere. Like, it's mining, it's not manufacturing. So eventually they're going to have to come back here and get it out of the ground. So I thought that was quite a good point.